Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Today we have a topic with us is quality of earnings. Well, quality of earnings is very important because all the investors, they try and analyze the company's quality earning, how far they are with the expectations and based on which the market numbers move. Over here, there's an example company that has been taken. But the most important part is, you know, the segregation of the data here for the amount of revenue which is coming from different end and how they're important. Well, we'll try and analyze everything in detail format. First, we will learn is what is quality of earnings. Now, the quality of the earning refers to the income generated from the core operations that is recurring the business, and it does not include the one-off revenues. That is the non-recurring part generated from the other sources. So quality of earning report is primarily used to assess the accuracy and sustainability of the historical earning as well as the achievability of the future projection. So evaluating the quality of the earning will help the financial statement user make judgment about the certainty of certain income and the prospects of the future. So in case of the acquisition, valuations are typically based on multiple like EBITDA. It is therefore critical for the buyer to understand historical earnings, their trends, key assumptions used for the forecast and sustainability of the earnings. So in order for an earning measure to be considered very high quality, it must reflect the cash flow and it must be sustainable. So earnings that are tied in account receivable, for example, do not have much value because despite being recognized, they have not yet been realized. Similarly, you know, the earnings that are not sustainable due to understated expenses, due to unfilled executive positions, as an example, would overstate your earnings. We'll take the next topic as the example, the point of discussion as the examples part. Let's say there's a company called ABC and it has the net income that has increased by 130%. So its sales has jumped, let's say, 200%. This is the net income part. This is the sales part. While, you know, it managed to bring down its general administrative cost close to 10%. This is your G&A. And on the contrary, say that, you know, the company's PQR sales were more as flat. So its expense rose only by 5%. Okay, and its net income increased by 130%. This is for the PQR Limited. Okay, so after change, you know, the way some of the assets and inventory depreciated. So looking at the above earning quality example, it is prudent to say that, you know, company ABC has better earning, as you can see, quality as compared to XYZ. Or PQR, because, you know, the company ABC earnings are from genuine improvement in the core operations of the company, and that is the sales products, and company PQR was able to record a similar rise in the net income mainly as a result of the accounting changes and changes in the depreciation, and the earning increases are little more than the paper profit. So it is important to note that company PQR hasn't done anything illegal or wrong, but its quality of the earning is lower than that of ABC. Now, there are some factors affecting the quality of the earnings. So what are the factors? See, according to the survey that was conducted by Emory University, 94.7% of the CFOs think that the earnings are either very important or somewhat important for the investor in valuing the company. So it is difficult to define the quality of the earning, and although there are no defined criteria to be considered. So taken as a whole, it can be summarized as a degree to which the earnings are either cash or non-cash, recurring or non-recurring, and based on the precise measurement or estimate that are subject to change. Now, if a company has managed to increase its earning every year by improving the cost of efficiency, or let's say the sales generated from the marketing company, that company would have a very high quality of its earning. And if any company's earnings are linked to the outside sources, such as increasing common prices, then the company would be seen having a low quality earning. Right. So also a company may report growth in sales, but this may be due to the growth of the credit sales, right? Usually analysts are not fond of losing credit policies or prefer organic growth in sales. So a company may have high net income, but at the same time, negative cash flows from the operation. This can be done through the artificial means. Now, there are some means or the indicators of overall earning quality. The financial statement can provide a very few indicators that readers can use to assess the earning of the high level. It is not limited to, but you can do that. It's Y to Y, that is year to year, or Q to Q, that is quarter to quarter, consistency of the accounting policies. Second, the overall degree of the estimation or the subjectivity in determination of the earnings. Then the trends in the reserve balances. Then the transparency, the most important in the disclosure, discussion of any non-recurring or unusual transaction. Sixth is the presence of the pro forma measure of the earnings. Seventh is, disclosure of the related party transactions. Eighth is the ratio of the net income to cash flow operations. Now, what are the measures that can be used? Measures for quality of earnings. Now, it should be noted that companies may manipulate earning measures such as EPS or price to earning ratio, the PE ratio, by, buying back the shares, which reduces the number of the shares outstanding. And due to this, a company with a declining net income may be able to post the EPS growth. So because the earning go up, the PE ratio goes down well and signaling that the stock is undervalued or on the sale. In actuality, the company simply repurchase the share, and it is particularly concerned with when companies take the additional debt to finance their stock purchase. So let me get to my conclusion part. Well, there is no single characteristics to measure the quality of earnings. However, the financial statement users, especially the audit committees, the management, and should be prudent in evaluating the quality of the financial reporting. So certain indicators and characteristics should be focused and assess the quality of earnings. So that's it for this particular topic.
If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.